Simon & Schuster Audio presents Mitch, Please. How Mitch McConnell sold out Kentucky and America, too. By Matt Jones. With Chris Tomlin. Read by the authors.
To the people of Kentucky, who opened their doors and hearts to us and who showed us kindness every step of the way. Note on interviews. We traveled to all 120 of these counties, and our descriptions of each are based upon these travels. Most of our interviews were done collectively, but some were done by each of us individually. For purposes of narration, we'll speak about all of the interviews in one voice. Introduction. Powell County, August 24th, 2019, rallying round the rooster. You know, if Mitch McConnell were a hound dog, even the fleas would stay away from him. It's a hot, sticky summer day in a city park in Stanton, Kentucky, and an elderly man in a flannel shirt and jeans is giving me the what for on all things Mitch McConnell. I don't like Mitch, and I don't know how anyone could. He's a weasel, and we got to get him out of there. We're at the Powell County Democratic Rally Round the Rooster event, a yearly celebration for local Democrats.
I looked for the rooster to rally round, never found it. Roosters are fast.
The event is filled with a disappearing breed, rural blue-collar Democrats, a group that once dominated Kentucky politics that now see their ranks thinning with each passing year. These folks are in desperate need of good news, and they've come here for a sweaty mix of politicking, hot dogs, and homemade potato salad. The Kentucky governor's election is just a few months away, and this large crowd is ready for change, not just in that race, but also another one a little more than a year away. The man continues, "Here's the thing, Matt. We can beat Mitch. We can. But we can't be running these people from big cities like Louisville and expect them to come and be able to talk to people out here in the country. We tried that. It don't work. Everybody in this state knows McConnell is awful, but they ain't gonna just vote for anybody. They might vote for you, though." I'm here in part because I'm considering a run against Senator Mitch McConnell in 2020. It's admittedly a ridiculous notion. McConnell's the second most powerful man in the country, spending his days ruining American democracy. I am a 41-year-old sports radio host who spends his days entertaining tens of thousands of Kentuckians by debating whether John Wall or Kyle Macy was the better former University of Kentucky basketball point guard. It isn't the normal biography of a United States Senate candidate. But defeating McConnell in this deep red state is going to take something out of the ordinary. I came to Powell County to give my first political speech as a potential candidate. All the big Democrats in Kentucky are here, each trying to energize the crowd. As I await my turn to speak, a line of locals comes over to say hello. They all tell me they love my show, they're huge UK fans, and they hate Mitch worse than anything. They aren't alone. In fact, if you're listening to this sentence, there's a very good chance that you hate Mitch McConnell. I can say that in part because the type of person who picks up a book with the title Mitch Please and a cartoon rendering of America's most reptilian politician on its cover is likely also someone who isn't a fan of the Senate Majority Leader. And why would you be? Mitch McConnell is the worst. If you're a rational human being with some degree of care for your fellow man, then you gotta dislike Mitch McConnell and everything he represents. Thankfully, most people do. McConnell's not only the least popular senator in America, he is uniquely disliked in his and my home state of Kentucky. In the survey research company Morning Consult's quarterly measurement of popularity in a senator's home state, McConnell's Kentucky approval rating nearly always comes in last in the entire nation. His approval rating has been as low as 18% and never, ever reaches higher than the mid-30s. In Kentucky, finding a true Mitch McConnell fan is like finding a fan of our arch rival, the Tennessee Vols. One might exist, but that person would be looked upon with a hearty mixture of scorn and pity. I was quite nervous as I walked up to give my speech to the crowd. The candidates for governor and attorney general had just spoken, and the crowd of a couple hundred people were in a mood to cheer. I had a set of talking points, but they were on a crumpled sheet of paper and hard to read. So I tossed them aside and got on stage and decided to speak from my heart. Mitch McConnell is the single most destructive force to Kentucky and America in my lifetime, and it's time we make it priority number one to send his ass out of Washington once and for all. The crowd burst into cheers. Whatever it is that you hate about politics the most, chances are Mitch McConnell is largely responsible for its existence. The massive amounts of money that have flooded our political elections? Mitch McConnell's responsible. The political divide that seems to be tearing our country apart at the seams? Thank you, Mitch. The gridlock that keeps Congress from passing any meaningful legislation? 3 for 3. The fact that Congress is full of career politicians who stay in office for way too long? Mitch again. The personal nastiness that is part of every political campaign? You get the picture. Mitch McConnell is quite simply everything wrong with American politics in 2020. So how did McConnell get to this level of power and destruction? And more importantly, why does he keep winning? The voters of Kentucky continue to re-elect a senator they despise, often by wide margins. In 2014, McConnell's race with challenger Allison Lundergan Grimes was supposed to be a close one. She was well-funded, a relatively popular Secretary of State, a young, fresh face that looked to be a perfect contrast to the old, stodgy curmudgeon from Louisville. Some early polls even showed Grimes leading, and national coverage painted the picture that Mitch could be on the brink. Then on Election Day, reality hit. McConnell won by an overwhelming 16-point margin, a result not even his most optimistic supporters would have imagined. The voters of Kentucky may hate him, but each election they look at him in the eye and say, "Thanks, Mother, may I have another?" Mitch is Kentucky's political cockroach, unable to be destroyed no matter how gross his transgressions. Even though he is so unlikable that he makes Texas Senator Ted Cruz look like Tom Hanks, Kentuckians keep choosing his obnoxious leadership while simultaneously honoring him as the least popular politician in America. How does this happen? Well, it's a question that perplexes outsiders and depresses Kentuckians across the bluegrass. I decided I had to find out the answer. I was raised in the small town of Middlesboro, deep in the heart of coal country in the Appalachian Mountains. Except for my years at Duke Law School and clerking on the D.C. and Fourth Circuits, I've spent my entire life in Kentucky. I have what my friend U of L African American Studies professor Ricky Jones calls an unnatural love affair with my state. I don't think he meant it as a compliment, but he is correct. I love my home state, and I consider its people the best you will find anywhere. So it's particularly appalling to me that a man who does such immense damage to our state and country is the face of the Commonwealth to the world.
Kentucky is one of four states. Virginia, Pennsylvania, and Massachusetts are the others that are technically commonwealths and not states. This difference is nothing important except it proves we're better than you.
It's important for you folks outside Kentucky to understand. We are not all like Mitch McConnell. In fact, none of us are like him. This state is unique and full of people for whom being a true Kentuckian really means something. We love the mountains, bourbon, basketball, bluegrass music, hunting, fishing, horse racing, preaching, singing, picking and grinning, all the staples of Kentucky life. We embrace those with whom we share a common culture and heritage. Mitch McConnell shares none of these traits with us. He exists as Kentucky's permanent hall monitor, looking over our shoulders with a scowl on his face, ready to perpetually kill our buzz. Mitch McConnell is as much a true Kentuckian as I am a true ballerina. And to have you believe he represents us is depressing. I'm here to dispel that notion. I'm the founder and host of Kentucky Sports Radio. It goes by KSR. It's the largest media outlet in Kentucky with 45 radio affiliates across the state and a website that gets as many as 200,000 visitors a day. Every day on Kentucky's airwaves, my crew, which includes co-hosts Ryan Lemon, Drew Franklin, and our producer Shannon the Dude, yes, he goes by Shannon the Dude, we talk not only about the latest in UK sports, but also the most important topics of daily life in Kentucky. We spend the day discussing and making jokes about Kentucky's latest news, sports, gossip, small town strange stories, and whatever else is on people's minds. It's a call-in show, and as such, our focus can differ wildly from segment to segment. One segment, we might discuss how hundreds of school teachers are marching on our state capitol to protest the governor's cuts to public education, while another deals with the scourge of a rumored werewolf murdering cattle in Wadi, Kentucky. Our goal is to reflect the conversations that are going on in any McDonald's at 8 in the morning anywhere in the state. And by the way, if you don't know that all across America, the major small-town conversations occur at McDonald's over morning coffee, then you're officially part of the cultural elite. It is Kentucky's radio town square, and for hundreds of thousands across the state, we are a part of their daily routines. As part of this job, I interact with Kentuckians of all types, from every corner of the state. For many of you listening to this, you may have some vague understanding that the University of Kentucky is good at basketball and that college sports are important in this part of the country. But that minimizes what UK, and to a lesser extent, U of L, sports mean to this state. In Kentucky, college sports, particularly college basketball, it's life. There's literally no event that brings the state together like a Kentucky Wildcats basketball game. And my life's work is sharing that obsession of the blue and white with my fellow Kentuckians. It's a truly unique platform.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.